We'll start with second part, and I will ask the Dr. Prachi Madam to share another case, third case, and then we'll discuss again the thyroid disorders. Okay, you can start.
Yes. Thank you, sir. So, welcome to the second part. And I was telling you the third case is of a benign tumor on the thyroid gland. So, this lady, Mrs. SP, her age was 49 in January 2012. I saw her in January 2012. So, what had happened, there was very interesting story that in 1991, the family was traveling by a car. And can you hear me?
Yeah.
Now, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. The family was traveling by a car, and they met with an accident, and the car got toppled. The ulti palti zali. All the 9 people survived with minor scratches and bruises and injuries here and there. But you know, it created great fear in her. Of course, everyone was very much scared for their lives. But this lady, interestingly, she developed clairvoyance. You know what she told me? That 91 saal se kya hai na? मुझे अगर ख्वाब में कुछ गलत शलत दिखता है या फिर ऐसे कुछ ख्वाब आ जाता है या ख्वाब में खून दिखता है ना, तो मेरे जो नजदीक के लोग हैं ना, उनको कुछ ना कुछ होता ही है. एक दो दिन में तो कुछ ना कुछ हो ही जाता है. एंड इंटरेस्टिंगली इन 2009, यू नो, हर सन वॉज बीटन अप, लाइक बीटन अप टू डेथ, नियरली डेड, खूब मार लो. एंड जस्ट 2 डेज बिफोर हिज यू नो दैट इंसिडेंट, शी हैड सीन ब्लड इन हर ड्रीम्स. मैंने खून देखा, अशफाक को बहुत बुरी तरीके से पीटा गया. इट वॉज सम राइवलरी, इंटरनल राइवलरी, बिकॉज हर एल्डर डॉटर वॉज मच ब्यूटिफुल. एंड द सैंड माफिया इन श्रीरामपुर एंड द रीजन, द सैंड माफिया, दैट पर्सन हैड प्रपोज हर हैंड इन मैरिज. ही हैड आस्क्ड हर टू मैरी हिम, बट शी सेड नो, शी फ्लैटली रिफ्यूज्ड. सो वॉट दैट माफिया डिड वॉज, he really took the revenge on her brother. Her brother was doing CA at that time, articleship and all that. And he wanted to done with him, but you know, he was nearly dead. Then people arrived and he was taken to the hospital. And then, you know, he went to Aurangabad. And he, even in 2020 is going on, he's in Aurangabad. He does not come to Srirampur. You know, trust me, the fear is so much. Okay, so going on. So what happened was, then of course she was afraid. She was afraid for her son. And what she developed in that state in 2009 was, you know, she developed a tumor on her thyroid gland. And she developed dry cough off and on. Whenever the season would change, she would have dry cough. And she started having pains in her joints. As in, you know, first she had pains in her ankles, then knees, then wrist, you know, all the joints. And not during the day, but the joints used to pain in the night when she used to lie down and all that. So the most interesting part for me was that she had developed that clairvoyance after being in that accident. After being so afraid, she had developed the clairvoyance. She had clairvoyant dreams. And of course, and there was this benign tumor. And interestingly, T3, T4, TSH, everything was normal. But in FNSC, they had said, I'll read that. I don't have the original report because it was like way back. But her FNSC report said that nodular hyperplasia having follicular epithelium plus thin colloid. The hyperplasia zalela hai. And plus they did USG also, thyroid gland. And what they saw was multiple nodules, and few nodules are showing calcification and features are more on the right side. Loni la kela hai sagar, everything was done at Loni, even her T3, T4, TSH or FNSC, and everything was done at Loni. And they had advised her, ye nikal lijiye aap, ye tumor hai, benign hai, nahi ye to cancer ka nahi hai, aap ye nikal lijiye, acha ho jayega. But someone had told her that yahan ye madam thyroid ke bare mein kuch karte hain, aap unse jaake puchhiyega. So, well, and so I looked up a few rubrics, and now I will share the screen about those rubrics with you. can you see ailments from fright or fear? Accident from means from the sight of accident, the fright is developed. Secondly, dreams, clairvoyant. Thirdly, ailments from fright or fear. Fourth is generalities, tumors, benign. And fifth is neck from Fartak's repertory, neck and nep. Neck means pudsa gala, nep means magsa gala, means neck and nep. So yes, aconite goes through and through. And since January, I gave her aconite. It's like, you know, she used to come like every 2 weeks. Means symptoms used to go down a bit, then again come back. So literally, I have repeated aconite 1 m bi-weekly up till August. Then what happened in August? So she started having bleeding in stools. And she started having burning after stools in the rectum. So typical, you know, they say piles che symptoms, the symptoms of piles. And she said, piles the mujhe 5-6 saal pehle the, wo dawa goli se theek ho gaya tha. Lekin ye wapas kaise aa gaya? Okay, so that was a good thing that, you know, the piles had come back. And of course, we say that the relationship of remedies, aconite is related to sulfur. Chronic of aconite is sulfur. So I gave her sulfur 200. And after sulfur, trust me, even just went away. People started asking her, kya operation karwaya kya aapne? Operation karwaya. But she said, no, dawa goli se hi theek ho gaya. Aconite 1 m bi-weekly, don athavda tun ekda. Yes, I have. It's like, and you know, later on in August, in July, I got hold of her 10 m and I gave her 10 m also. And after aconite 10 m, she started having this old pile symptoms coming back, and then sulfur 200 only, because that okay, he's local hai, burning hota hai, sulfur 200, a few doses, don teenas doses dile, not more than that. And then as if by magic, her nodules just went away. Her clairvoyance did not go away, but her nodules went away. That was really fantastic. And you know, because I had read in because as sir has told me, I had read in Manashakti that Swami Vidyanananda had given one of his disciples had seen two trucks colliding with each other, and after that, seeing that accident, he developed a nodule on his thyroid gland. And Swami Vidyanananda had given a homeopathic remedy to that disciple of his, and the tumor had gone away. So I had read it. Kutla tari Diwali anka madhe, Manashakti cha Diwali anka madhe, in Diwali special magazine, Manashakti is publishing magazine monthly since say 1990 or 92, but and I since I was in fourth standard, I'm reading that magazine, and so yes, I had read, so I was very sure that ahe aplyakade manje thyroid gland var nodule ala tar ahe homeopathic madhe kahi tari ahe. And yes, after sulfur, yes, trust me, after sulfur completed the whatever the work had started by aconite, sulfur really completed it. After aconite 10 m, actually the old symptoms came back. And by my reading of literature, I knew that ki ahe ki asa nodule homeopathic medicine ni purvi koni tari theek kelela ahe, Swami Vidyanananda yani theek kelela ahe. So I was really happy. Wow, Swami ji, majhyakade pan ashi case ali. I also saw the same case. Sir, over to you, sir.
Anything else you have to share, or you have shared whatever you have?
Ankin sir, fakma don slides fakta dakhau ka, those were like ki te patient baki cha medicine var hote, baki cha diagnosis chalu hote, pan fakta ek hormonal phase aali hoti bas, ek TSH raise zalo hota, asha donas mhanje asha kadhi kay mhanal kadun thevlele ahet cases, fakta tya don share karte. त्या दोन पीपीटी म्हणते दोन स्क्रीनशॉट शेअर करते. जस्ट गिव मी 2 मिनिट्स.
ओके.
सो So yes, if you can see, it was the rubrics were selected for this girl who had lip and tip syndrome. Lip and tip syndrome म्हणजे की ओठ आणि जी नख असतात तिथला आसपासचा सगळा भाग पांढरा होणं आणि हा जवळजवळ असाध्य मानला जाणारा विकार आहे ल्युकोडर्मा मधला. अँड आणि तिचं TSH 8 आलं होतं. अँड सो ऍज दे वेर अन एज्युकेटेड फॅमिली दे आस्क्ड मी की तुम्ही काहीतरी मेडिसिन द्या आणि हिचं एवढं TSH कमी करून द्या नाहीतर गायनेकॉलॉजिस्ट हे सुरू करून देतील म्हणे एल्ट्रॉक्सिन सुरू करतील. आय जस्ट टूक द केस अँड येस शी हॅड ड्रीम्स ऑफ ड्रिंकिंग ड्रीम्स ऑफ स्नेक्स ऑल्सो अँड रिसेंटली शी हॅड हॅड क्लॉटेड मेन्सेस and she really liked pani puri. So the moment she said pani puri, to yes, fantastic, medorinum. And looking at all the things, I really, trust me, I did not know that medorinum is also seen in dreams of snakes. Yes, and it had dreams of drinking. So yes, medorinum 1 m, one dose fakta dila hota, only that one dose, and after 3 months the TSH was done and it was down to 5. And just one more case, that in a known case of schizophrenia, that lady was known schizophrenic, was under the psychoactive drugs for 12 years, and of course her weight had increased and she wanted to reduce her weight. I said no, please do some TT4 TSH, because I think and I asked her ki pari madhe kai problem hai to ka. She said yes, now the menses have gone scanty and scanty. First I used to have like menses for 3-4 days and now just I bleed for 1 day, and TSH was done and it was 12. So I took her case and whatever I saw, just tevdes rubrics me dakhote. Okay, so you can see menses disturbances of menses scanty, urine more than she drinks, and drugs abuse of in general. See, माझं लाडकं रुब्रिक आहे युरिन मोर दॅन ड्रिंक्स. अँड शी हरसेल्फ सेड, हा आय डोंट से दॅट हा तुम्ही जास्ती वेळा बाथरूमला जाता का. नो, शी हरसेल्फ सेड हा नाऊ दॅट यू से, तुम्ही म्हणताय मग माझ्या लक्षात येतंय की मी पाणी तसं एक दोनच ग्लास पिते, पण खूप जास्ती वेळा लघवी करायला जाते आणि खूप जास्ती लघवी होतीये असं मला वाटतंय. अँड हर हजबंड वॉज वरीड की बाबा मग काय, मग म्हणजे शुगरचं हे करावं का काय, टेस्ट करावी का. सर नो, मला नाही वाटलं त्या क्षणी, पण येस TSH मात्र 12 होतं हे अगदी खरं आहे. अँड इट वॉज वे बॅक इन 2013 or 2014 मे बी. आणि यू कॅन सी पल्सेटीला सल्फर नक्सोमिका, बट आय गेव हर नक्सोमिका. सो आय विल टेल यू हाऊ डीड आय गिव्ह हर नक्सोमिका. आय गेव हर नक्सोमिका 200 ऑन 4th डे ऑफ मेन्सेस, ऑन एव्हरी 4th डे ऑफ मेन्सेस फॉर 4 सायकल्स, for continuously for 4 months, and after 4 months yes, TSH had reduced. पण ते तुम्हाला विचारतात की एवढं कमी करून द्याल का, नाहीतर म्हणे एल्ट्रॉक्सिन सुरू करतील, मोठे डॉक्टर एल्ट्रॉक्सिन सुरू करतील, त्यापेक्षा तुम्ही काहीतरी द्याल का. अँड दोज टू केसेस वेर रिसेंटली डायग्नोज विथ रेस TSH, म्हणून खूप कमी वेळात त्याचा खूप चांगला फायदा झाला की कमी वेळामध्ये, बिकॉज रिसेंटली डायग्नोज. जर खूप वेळ झाला असेल तर मात्र येस वेळ लागू शकतो. Yes, so I think over to you, sir.
Okay. So, thank you, Prachi, sharing your cases. And few more things I want to share with all of you regarding the things that whenever you used to treat the thyroid disorders, whatever it may be, whether they are the hypothyroidism, whether it is hyperthyroidism, whether it is a thyrotoxicosis with goiter, number of cases comes to you when you start practicing. Generally, a chronic state generally comes in your day-to-day practice. I'm lucky enough that I have both the practice. I have chronic cases as well as acute OPD also in homeopathy. But generally in our early practice, we get such types of chronic cases. And nowadays, these endocrinal disorders is the most important disorders which are quite common with the patient. So we get such types of cases again and again. If you are getting hypothyroidism, it's quite little. I will say that it will be better to treat hypothyroidism very easily than hyperthyroidism. Because hypothyroidism, few things are there with you. Because in hypothyroidism, there is a weight gain, generally, common. Second important thing, all the metabolic processes, they happen to be slow. There is dullness, sluggishness, the activity is decreased, memory sometimes lost, hair falls, edema all over, the generalized edema. All those features which are related with the BMR where is very less. In such cases, the diet I used to suggest is that they should follow the same diet which I used to tell the patients of a diabetes. That is, they should reduce their weight. Automatically, the thyroid settles very easily. The disparity develops. Whenever the hypothyroidism develops, there is a disparity that because of hypothyroidism, patient becomes slow, dull, sluggish, but he eats less. And that's why generally in such types of patients, they go on putting the weight and it goes so much and requirement is very less, requirement is not fulfilled and that's why the thyroid goes on increasing. This is quite common. So ask the patient always to take twice a day food, nothing in between, absolutely nothing. If they want that, they can have a salad in between, nothing more than that. So if you keep the patients on specific diet, that twice a meal only, nothing in between, no tea, no milk, no fruits, nothing else in between. If you ask them to reduce the weight along with exercises, I ask them to go for a walk at least for 45 minutes along with 12 Surya Namaskars, or I generally ask that they can go for cycling. Because of which weight reduction, the requirement of thyroid automatically settles and the hypothyroidism starts decreasing. This is very common, that these are the measures which are very essential while treating the hypothyroidism. And then whatever your remedy which comes out, whether it is calcarea, whether it is any remedy depending upon the patient's constitution, it is not specific that. But quite commonly you can get the calcarea in such types of hypothyroid cases. I used to give thyroidinum along with that. Thyroidinum 6x twice a day, even for months I used to give them. Instead of, and second thing which question that asked by Dr. Shaila, sir, how to reduce the doses if patient is on eltroxine or thyroxine? So generally I used to keep the same dose at start when I start the treatment. Because of thyroxine itself, the patient's weight reduction stops and he starts reducing, the edema stops. So instead of stopping it directly, you keep the patient on the same thyroxine for the first consultation, add your remedies. After 15 days or within 1 month, see the patient. If he reduces by 3 or 4 kgs within first month, then start reducing the thyroid gradually. If patient is consuming 100 microgram, then you can ask the patient to take 75 microgram, so that will be sufficient. Then keep that patient again on the same diet, continue with your remedy and find it out whether patient goes on reducing or not. After 1 month, the patient should reduce again 3-4 kg. If the weight is too much, if female is there, I used to ask them to keep their weight generally between 50 to 54. And in case of males, I ask them generally to keep weight between 70 to 74, depending upon their heights and age. But preferably, I ask to reduce in that specific area. Till that period, gradually go on tapering the eltroxine. Don't stop it immediately, because it helps to hasten the recovery in the patient. And that's why it is not an allopathic. Basically, it is a supplement which you are giving. It is not generally allopathic at that time. So think about it. And you go on giving the thyroidinum 6x. And then when you understand that there is no more edema of the patient, patient's weight is coming directly normal, then you start reducing and stop the eltroxine. And afterwards, when you come to the very clear cut reports of thyroid profile, then ask the patient to do it again and again and confirm that if it has been settled, stop the thyroidinum 6x also. keep the patient on placebo during that time. Observe what happens. And then after a month or two, repeat the thyroid and find it out whether it remains in a euthyroid state. If the patient remains in euthyroid state, then you stop the placebo, ask the patient to keep follow up every monthly, and just go on observing, clinically examining. And once in 3 months, 4 months, ask them to do a thyroid. And every time it is not necessary to do T3, T4, TSH. Just do a TSH and which confirms you whether patient is euthyroid or not. So every time it is not necessary to spend so much of money by doing T3, T4, TSH. So best way is to give, only ask the patient to do a TSH and at least keep a watch on the patient at least another year or two. Sometimes it happens that patient can slip back again, and that's why you have to keep the watch on the patient and ask the patient to have at least once or once in a month or once in 2 months for the follow-ups. So that is for regarding the hypothyroidism. It's difficult to treat is the hyperthyroidism generally, because here you cannot do anything. At least there is in your hand in hypothyroidism, ask the patient to reduce the weight. Here they have to increase because they are already lost weight and it is in kgs. So 5 kgs, 10 kg loss is there generally in cases of hyperthyroidism, and along with BMR is increased, the sweating is marked, the patient is having a tremors or trembling, the tachycardia, palpitations, all those features are there. Such types of cases, yes, patient generally have a good appetite, but they lose the ferret. So that is very typical with the, you have to find it out such types of remedies like iodine or iodide group. Whatever may be, it might be a variety iodide, calcare iodide, natrum iodide, whatever may be there. Iodide group generally comes in hypothyroidism as a very important remedy. So that you have to consider. Here, your specific remedy or constitutional remedy, anti-miasmatic remedy, plays a very vital role to tackle the hyperthyroidism. So there, you ask the patient to take a good diet, that is nutritious diet should be there, because it is utilized every time. So patient should have a very good diet, nutritious diet during the hyperthyroidism, so that he cannot lose the weight thereafter. And one more remedy I used to add in such types of patient is alfalfa at that time. So giving alfalfa along with your constitutional medicine, alfalfa you can give either in 6x potency, or alfalfa you can give in mother tincture 15 drops twice a day, and you can continue with that. That works in such types of cases. So if patient is on neomarchazole, that is another thing. You don't stop neomarchazole straightforward, because it is not neomarchazole they used to give. Along with neomarchazole, I think they give some beta blockers or certain remedies which maintain the heart rate. I suggest that instead of directly stopping all those medicines, taper it gradually, so that patient will not have or patient will not slip back again, and then gradually go on reducing the allopathic medicines. Basically, neomarchazole you have to stop, and then whatever may be the beta blocker or something which they used to give, that also you have to stop gradually. So in both cases, tapering is very important instead of directly stopping the allopathic medicines. So sometimes a patient, In such types of cases,
whenever
video, so tikadcha video yeto var kare
chalu sir.
So in such types of cases, you have to handle very carefully. Pathological cases, whatever it may be there with you, you have to tackle very, very carefully, because you should not interfere with the allopathic medicines directly. Number of times, as Vaibhav have said over there, that it patient may go into withdrawal. Yes, definitely, this is the thing. Same is true when you are handling the hypertension cases. If the patient is on antihypertensive, don't stop antihypertensive directly, because sometimes it may happen that patient may go into the very severe blood pressure and can cause a cerebrovascular accident. So whenever you are treating such types of disorders which can produce something turmoil in the patient, you should be careful while reducing the doses and gradually go on reducing, and you can get desired result with your homeopathic medicine. Then stop those medicines the allopathic medicines completely. This is caution, what I used to say. And if you get very typical goiters over there, and if the swelling is hard enough, never forget to give a calcarea fluor to the patient. Calcarea fluor, whatever may be the patient's remedy, it might be conium, it might be anything, depends. It is very, very important. But calcarea fluor is a very important remedy in goiter. One more hint for all of you, that if it is a simple goiter, if it is not nodular and simple goiter, generally we miss the remedy, and that is the spongia. Spongia is a very good remedy for the simple goiters, and it brings back the thyroid again to the normal level. I have seen number of times the results with this remedy. So these are very important things from practice point of view. So whenever you are treating thyroid, always think what you are exactly treating. Second important suggestion for all of you, all the practitioners and students, is that if there is a diagnosis, very clear-cut diagnosis is there, that patient is having nodular thyrotoxicosis, first open the books. You give whatever may be the remedy you feel to the patient, and then read that nodular thyrotoxicosis. Understand the pathology. Correlate that pathology with your materia medica, with your repertory. If you do such a type of study, you will develop very good therapeutic thought or therapeutic aspect in your mind, and that will be useful at the time whenever you are treating next cases. And even though it looks like prejudiced, but it is not prejudiced, but you must develop such types of therapeutic knowledge regarding the diagnosis, because you must understand the depth of the action of a remedy, whether that remedy will going to cover that pathology. That thought should be there. So if you are prescribing, as she has shown, that aconite has cured, but aconite has not cured. Yes, aconite has acted in that acute state with which the patient was recovered, or he was on the path of recovery, but it was cured with the help of a sulfur. Sulfur has a depth to bring back that again to the normal. So we have to understand the depth of the remedy. And that depth of the remedy you can understand when you read the materia medica sentence by sentence, understanding the every sentence from the materia medica. So, and for that purpose, I suggest that you must go through the Kent's materia medica, even homeopathic drug pictures by M.L. Tyler, or Chaudhary's, N.M. Chaudhary's materia medica. The source book you must read again and again, and understand whenever you are reading, you read it sentence by sentence. Understand that sentence. Think about that this remedy, with this remedy, how can the patient will going to come to me? Think about that. Yeah, even in Borick's materia medica, the first paragraph I used to say, read it again and again. Then you can understand, yes, how much this remedy can do. So you have to understand the pace also. The pace is very important. Sir, aconite has a very fast pace. Belladonna is having very fast pace. But if you are dealing with the baratas or calcareas or wherever there is carbon, generally the pace is very slow. leave the patient space, it's too fast, and you are giving calcarea. Calcarea will not going to do anything immediate. You cannot expect anything at that time. That pace should be matched at the same time. If a patient is very slow and dull and you are giving aconite, chamomilla, belladonna, nothing will going to happen because the pace is not getting matched. So it is not only the remedy which is matching. You have to consider what is the pace of the remedy, what is the depth of the remedy, where it enters, where whether it reaches to the inner core, whether it reaches to the bony structure. Accordingly, you can think about the miasm cells. And this is what is needed when you prescribe for the pathology. So handling the pathology, you must be very thorough enough regarding the knowledge of your materia medica. So with repertory, you can come to the group of remedies, but with the help of a materia medica, you can reach to the target remedy with the help of a understanding of that remedy properly. So this is my suggestion that you, whenever you are treating all those cases, must give importance to the understanding of the remedy. Second important thing which I want to highlight, whenever you are treating thyroid disorders, now my suggestion is that you have understood the remedy. Now you go to the therapeutics part of the 12 tissue remedies by Schussler. Read at least daily, it is given alphabetically. Go with at least 4-5 conditions. Ki aaj jhopnyapurvi mi 5 therapeutic conditions vachnar ahe, tyachyanantaras mi jhopnar ahe. Decide it first and read them. It is very nicely elaborated by the Schussler along with the clinical cases presentation. And it is not done by Schussler only. It is collected by Boric and Dive from different sources. And those cases are very interesting so that you become clinically thorough while applying the remedies. So that therapeutic aspect of the 12 tissue remedies, one must learn by heart and go with at least 5 conditions per day so that you can revise them again. And last part of that book, Biochemic Remedy, the last part is the repertory. And that also is essential. So if you have a case of thyroid, just open next chapter in the repertory, find it out whether there is any specific goiter like symptom is there or rubric is there or not. You look there whether there is any thyroid rubric is there or not. You try with your own intelligence and with your own thoughts. If you go on experimenting with the books, with the repertory, then you can acknowledge number of things from them. So every time it should not be a spoon feeding. Spoon feeding is to start with. Now you know how to approach. I have given you the number of approaches. I have given you how to learn the Allen's keynotes, how to learn from the Boric's Materia Medica, how to learn from the Kent's Materia Medica, N.M. Chaudhary's Materia Medica. Number of books we have discussed and whole series about the 12 tissue remedy. Now you have understood that how sir used to learn. Now it is your duty to go ahead with similar aspects. Understand them carefully, so that you can apply. It immediately reflects your mind whenever you are treating such difficult disorders. Immediately comes up when you read them thoroughly. So this is what I want to share with you. I will suggest tomorrow there will be a session again on the biocombinations. First 5 we have finished. Tomorrow we'll go ahead with certain 5 or 10, depends on as time permits. But my suggestion is that before coming for the lecture, just go and review those lectures again so that you can acknowledge the pathophysiology of those remedies again and again, and then it will be very easy to understand those things. So that's all for today. You have understood a lot of things we have discussed, and thanks to Dr. Prachi, she has shared 3 cases open-mindedly with all of you. And number of practitioners who are there, my suggestion is that put your queries regarding use of biochemics or biocombinations in my inbox, so that tomorrow I will deal with them along with the explanation of a biocombinations also. So you must And second, one more thing I forgot to tell you, that I have opened a Facebook account by the name of Dr. Prasad Arvind Resort. It is. There are two accounts. Already 5,000 followers are there in first. That's why it was closed. So this second one, which I have started, my suggestion is that there are only homeopaths I am adding. I am not adding any person other than homeopath. So in your profile, it should be mentioned from which college you have learned and where do you practice. Everything should be there so that I can add you in the that Facebook account, be my friend. So thereafter, we can shift towards the homeopathic Facebook friends account, that is the Prasad Arvind Resort. So we can discuss number of things, and thanks a lot for attending all those sessions, and go through again YouTube channel. So ask your friends to subscribe the channel and learn the homeopathy by heart, propagate the homeopathy. That is the need of the time, because we are going in a difficult time nowadays because of COVID-19. Homeopathy, people are understanding regarding the homeopathy, but it should not happen that they can get wrong aspects about the homeopathy. So one should be very, very clear with their understanding of the homeopathy. Thank you very much for sharing. And tomorrow we'll meet 2:30 on Facebook Live again, so we can learn a lot regarding biocombination. Thank you very much. Close the...
Thank you, sir.